ever feel the need for speed? What about breaking the speed of sound in a fighter jet? Think you could handle all the extreme G-forces during a dogfight? Alright, Maverick, let's see if you have what it takes to be the Top Gun. Buckle your seatbelt and strap in, it's gonna be a wild ride. This is Your Body On, Being a Fighter Pilot. Flying a fighter jet is more than just climbing into a cockpit and taking off into the wild blue yonder. It involves intense training, study, and practice. From learning to pitch and roll to pulling high Mach speeds, piloting a fighter jet is no easy feat. Could all these intense maneuvers affect your body over time? And what are the health risks involved? To be accepted as a United States Air Force fighter pilot, you have to have 20/20 vision uncorrected. You can't be colorblind. You also can't have a history of hay fever, asthma, or allergies after the age of 12. You must be taller than 1.63 meters to ride this ride and shorter than 2 meters. And that's not all. You need to be able to swim 1.6 kilometers in a flight suit. Piece of cake. You'll also need to pass a physical fitness exam called the Fighter Aircrew Conditioning Test. It will determine if your body can withstand high G-forces. Feeling woozy yet? So, how could flying a fighter jet affect your body? To find out, let's climb into the cockpit and take off. 1G is the force of gravity felt at the Earth's surface. When flying, sudden accelerations result in an increase in the force of gravity on your body. During aerobatic maneuvering, like high-speed rotations, you could feel as much as 9 Gs. That's 9 times the force of gravity. You could suffer from tunnel vision as the blood pressure in your eyes decreases. And you might pass out from a lack of oxygen as blood flows away from your brain. This is G-induced loss of consciousness, or GLOC. Throughout the 1990s, the US Air Force lost one pilot every year to GLOC. So watch your speed there, Ace, and don't try anything too fancy. You'll need to keep an eye on the enemy when you're in a dogfight. That means aggressively rotating, flexing, and extending your body. You'll be straining your neck and upper back. You might suffer from G-measles or geasles, which are clusters of small bruises from ruptured capillaries. Experienced pilots learn to build resistance to the force and stay conscious. You'll learn breathing methods and how to flex certain body parts like your legs in a technique known as the anti-G straining maneuver. Like scuba divers, pilots can get the bends. Surfacing too quickly causes the rapid release of gas and forms dangerous bubbles in the bloodstream. For pilots, this is a risk in an emergency landing if you descend too rapidly from an extreme height. You'll be grounded for 24 hours, and you may get decompression sickness, which can cause joint pain and headaches. However, it's not just sore necks and the bends you have to worry about. A 2013 study found that regular exposure to high altitudes and pressurized air could cause brain lesions. These lesions are associated with cognitive decline or mild dementia in the elderly. The higher you fly, the more you're exposed to cosmic radiation, usually filtered through the atmosphere. Exposure to ultraviolet and ionizing radiation has raised concerns about an increased risk of prostate cancer in fighter pilots. But there's no conclusive evidence. Let's face it, being a fighter pilot is risky business and is a highly demanding occupation. You'd have to train for years and stay extremely fit, but you'd also have the honor of serving your nation. Okay, now that you've come back down to Earth, what would it be like to spend a year in space? Well, we'll take that giant step on another episode of Your Body On.